Hi friends, now let us talk about a few words of the Olympic Games and sports. Nearly 3,000 years ago, in the year 776 BC, Olympic Games and sports started in Greece. Nearly 14 countries only participated. At the beginning of the Olympics, first they started a running race in a old stadium. After that, wrestling. Besides running, added, and then some other games also started along with running. Some sports related to throws also started. So, Olympics has very old history. You see, in human life, games and sports play a vital role. You must be fit not only mentally, but physically. To get a physical fitness, one must play games and sports, which are very vital to keep or to maintain our body health. If the body is healthy, the mind will be also very healthy. There is a proverb in English, a healthy body will have a healthy mind. Yes, that is sure. 100% it is correct. But worldwide competition. Nowadays, nearly there are 200 countries in the world. American countries, European countries, African countries, Australian countries, Asian countries. But it is very unfortunate to say our Asian countries are lagging behind at the initial stage of the Olympics. The Americans, Russians, Australians, Europeans like Germans, Dutch people, France, England dominated in winning gold medals and silver medals, whereas Asians are able to score only bronze medals. There are so many reasons for it. The physical fitness, the bone structure, the muscle power play a vital role. The Americans, Russians, Europeans, Australians have very good physique. Africans also have very good physique, but they didn't have proper diet. because of the poverty, Africans unable to compete. But nowadays, the people of Kenya are winning the gold medals in long races, 10,000 meters, 15,000 meters, like that. As the sports and games expanded, India also, which is one of the Asian countries, dominated in hockey game, continuously won gold medals. Our sister country, Pakistan, also dominated in the hockey. Because of their skills, in India, Dhyan Chand, Roop Chand brothers scored record number of goals against Europeans. They created many records in hockey field. Pakistan players also created records in hockey games. Later, the Europeans changed their skills, changed their playing system. They conveniently adopted a skill which is suitable for their body language. Till then, they participated, they showed immense skill and won medals in hockey. India and Pakistan slowly lost their command over the game. They lost the grip in scoring gold or silver medals. So now, Australia, Netherlands, Brazil, showing immense command over the hockey. Even in football, India failed to qualify. Many of the Asian countries failed to qualify in football because of the weakness in their physical structure. They are not strong enough to play 90 minutes. To play 90 minutes, one should have very good stamina. The Europeans who live in cold climatical conditions can play hours together because of the heartbeat is very slow. Coming to the hot countries like India, Pakistan, other Asian countries, their heartbeat is more. So, because of the heartbeat, the Asians easily get tired and unable to play 90 games and unable to run long distances. In throws, that is short put, discus and javelin, we are lagging very, very behind. Asians are unable to qualify for Olympic Games because of the weak physique. They can't throw heavy objects like shot put and discus to a long distance. So they failed to qualify even to play, to participate in Olympics. Japanese letter, Japanese, Chinese, Koreans improved their skills in all sectors of games and sports. Now they are able to score maximum medals in games as well as sports events. Asian countries now dominating, some of the Asian countries dominating in present Olympics, particularly China, but India still lagging behind. Why India lagging behind? No proper encouragement in India, no sophisticated facilities to practice games and sports. Mainly the turfs are very poor, the grounds are very poor, the equipment which we use, the shoes or the techniques are not up to the standard. Government, the governments which are in the center and the state, unable to provide proper funds to sports and games because they concentrate in welfare schemes, free programs, but they are not ready to spend on sports and games. No proper stadiums in rural areas, no proper ground facilities. There are multiple reasons. No proper coaches. We have to appoint foreign coaches who are very expensive. So in our budget, in budget allocations, the governments are focusing on the vote bank. They're spending millions on the vote banks, but not on sports and games. You see, in boxing, see their physique, comparing Indian physique. I agree that physics is important, but at the same time, skills. Indians, if they are given proper training regarding skills, they can get medals, gold medals, silver medals. So they should focus on games and sports. See, India, very unfortunate to say, India is unable to conduct Olympic Games in our country because it is very, very expensive. If you conduct Olympics, so some billions of rupees you need to construct a Olympic city, which is not possible in the present condition, India, to conduct Olympics, because only advanced countries, America, North America, South America, Australia, New Zealand, European countries, can conduct Olympics because they are very rich and developed countries. So, Olympics are today conducted 4 years once. But they changed the Olympic system. They divided Olympics into two: Winter Olympics, Summer Olympics. So now it is easy to conduct, to encourage the sports persons across the world. The developed countries have ultra modern facilities. You see, in shooting, in games, important games like basketball, volleyball, football, hockey, which need much physical fitness. And running 100 meters, 200 meters is not easy. For swimming, one should have very good technique as well as physique. Then only our Asian countries can dominate. See here, hockey match between India and Great Britain. Even today, Indians showing some special skill, beating some of the European countries. Still, we have to change our game method. As Europeans changed, they give long passes so that they will not be tired easily. But Indians, very short passes, dribbling, too much dribbling, too much selfish game. So we should play for the team spirit, not individual spirit. But many of the Indian players are very selfish. They won't pass the ball. They want to score the goal individually to get the name and fame. It is very bad and unhealthy habit. So we need some foreign coaches. See, our rural talent have efficiency but no skill. You see, in shooting, Indian tribals are very excellent. What they need? Some coaching, some technique, latest technique. You might have known Bomba, a tribal who is good at shooting. So, India should bring out the rural talent. So, to dominate the Europeans. You see how the ground, see, observe the ground, how beautiful, synthetic ground, smooth ground. So on these grounds, the Indians have no grip. They can't run. They can't move easily. But Europeans can run, pass, play quickly, sharply, elegantly, efficiently. Whereas Indians failed because of the shoes. They are not provided standard shoes. If they are provided standard shoes, Indians can dominate the world. So you see the tally, India's results, three continuous victories. But whereas India failed to meet Australia, which is very efficient, elegant, more skilled than Indian players. So to meet the competition, we need some, our sports people need good diet, healthy diet that gives physical strength. See how he passed the ball towards the goal. He is successful in scoring a goal. So, we should provide some healthy food first of all. And proper training, proper coaches, under the guidance of proper coaches, if they are trained, they can show their immense skills, brilliant skills. Who can dominate the world, who can challenge the world. So unless and until our Indians are given proper fitness to them by giving, providing good diet. And one more thing, politics entered the sports and games also in India. Very unfortunate. Why in sports and games politics? Politics dictating, commanding whom to select, whom not to select. They are giving priority to urban people, urban sports persons. Why can't they give importance to the rural talent? One more thing. North Indians are given multiple chances, whereas South Indian sports persons, games persons are not given proper priority. You observe in cricket, how many South Indians are there? Though they are very good spin bowlers, fast bowlers, good batsmen, who can change the scenario with their batting power, bowling power. Eerapalli Prasanna, Chandrasekhar, Venkat Raghavan, they change the scenario in bowling, and in batting, Gundappa Viswanath, beautiful player, Azharuddin, wonderful batsman. But what to do? South Indians are neglected. In the team of 15, only 2 or 3 South Indian players, remaining total North Indian players. Why this discretion in games and sports, which depends on individual skill, individual capacity? So, I request the politicians not to enter into games and sports. Give freedom. There must be autonomous body in games and sports. In olden days, no politics in games and sports. That's why players dominated the world. Dhyan Chand, Roop Chand. Dhyan Chand is a wizard of hockey, a magician. No one expects how or which direction Dhyan Chand play? He shows one direction and plays into another direction. He scored dozens of goals in hockey. We defeated the other countries 24-0, 22-0. They didn't give any opportunity to foreigners to score at least a single goal, but they scored dozens of goals. That's why India have immense talent. There are some diamonds in India, not only North India, not only South India, East and West India. Please give priority to the efficiency. Don't show politics, partiality in selection. Give them freedom. Don't interfere. Don't recommend to remove a player to add his own player. That is not good. We have seen some games. That is ladies hockey. Shah Rukh Khan, coach. In South Indian film also, a rural girl who is very talented in cricket. Because of her poverty, illiteracy, she was discouraged, dismissed from the team. Later, she had given an opportunity to show her skill. So please, in Amir Khan's wrestling film, the ruler, his daughters, though they are very capable, very powerful in wrestling, there also discretion, partiality made his daughters, but at last worth is recognized. That you should not forget, my dear politicians. Worth will be recognized one day or other. So unless and until politics is away from the games and sports, our Indian players, though they have very good skills, efficiency, they can't score medals in the international level. You see, Sindhu, she tired to fight against his opponent. She had very good physique, but no proper encouragement to her. Ladies also, victims of discretion, partiality. So, I request all, try to encourage games and sports in India so that our sport persons, games persons can show their capabilities, winning gold and silver medals. At least now, some of one or two silver medal, some bronze medal chances are there, but this is not good. India is a big country, population 130 crossed. So you should bring up a very good games and sports persons to fly India flag high over in the Olympic stadiums. Thank you. Thank you, Vandana. I am sorry Just I want to say the condition of the Indian players. Not that I am criticizing the governments, I have no capacity, but I want to bring some truths before them so that they can take some action to make India shine once again. Thank you one and all.